Hello everyone, and welcome back to Veil of Sanity, Episode 6, Part 2.
Alright, so the question to the crew. Would you like to just sort of fast forward through some cleanup and get on with things, or would you like to roleplay out the recovery?
I think we need to have a board meeting, but I don't think we'd have to do the recovery bit.
I think,
there are some pertinent things. First, you have immune me. We can, there are in-game, like, rolling effects so that you don't actually have to RP out the suppression of a mutiny. But if you felt that you would prefer to stay in an RP mode and kind of run through the suppression of a mutiny, then we can do that. Otherwise, we can make some checks to suppress the mutiny.
Well, during this, am I going to be incapacitated for another further 10 hours or...
You are all this is happening, like, bam, it's happening, like, you pull away from the room, flamers start gouting out, they're purifying flame. Octavius is on the comm. Jack informs you that several levels have gone dark. Octavius is rallying his men to find out what happened. It seems that bands of men have gone crazy. Others are unhappy with how things are being done. Many rumors are abroad. The crew starts to choose sides.
Meanwhile, the captain's like, "Oh, praise the Emperor! The Emperor's great! Woo!"
The captain can stop doing that if he so chooses, but remember, you're taking negatives.
I stop doing that. And start trying to get my shit together. What penalty? I get penalties on fellowship, don't I?
Fellowship, yes. Intelligence, and willpower all at minus 10.
Minus 10. I can deal with that. I can deal with that.
So, does this happen before, while, or after Claudette has walked off?
If you would respond differently, you can retcon your actions, but
so
it's basically all happening at the same time.
Okay, because I said I make it it depends solely on how Marius is acting at the last moment I look at him, right? So because I said I would walk away and turn off my comm device because Marius was just there muttering prayers to himself. But if he actually is taking action, I wouldn't walk off like that, I guess.
So. Seems to be rallying himself somewhat. You can still catch nervous whispers of prayer underneath what's going on.
When you kind of glance over to me, you see initially that my kind of eyes are glazed over, but as you kind of fix your gaze on me, they kind of come back into focus. And I kind of narrow my eyes and get to my feet. And I mean, from my character, and this is kind of about character, Beth, with my traits, I'm iron discipline, I'm fairly intimidating. Would me being covered in gore and viscera help my intimidation checks?
Are you covered in gore and viscera, though?
Well, I've just been on the floor up to... In 3 or 4 inches of blood, and I've been crawled in a ball, so I'm going to be covered in blood and gore.
I thought you said you fell to your knees. So yes, from the knees down, or let's say the thighs down, you have red pants.
All right, okay. When I was viewing praying, I was kind of seeing, like, put your face to the ground, kind of praying.
Whatever you wanted to do.
Yeah, so I'm a sight of blood and gore, and I stand up and I vox to Octavius. Are they dealt with?
He's right next to you.
Oh, he's right next to me. Are they dealt with? The astral.
Yes. Plane. Though your friends delayed at the action.
I will deal with them in time. For now, they're still loyal, and we must retake the ship. by any means necessary, and I cock my bolt pistol and start walking towards the lower decks.
Okay. So are you saying you want to roleplay this? You want to go through the scenario, or did you just want to make some checks?
It's up to the other guys, but I would quite like to do it. Seeing as it's our first mutiny, would quite like to experience the mutiny.
I'm gonna ask you, Captain, do you need me more on the bridge or more with you with this mutiny?
Secure the bridge in the upper decks with Jack.
Okay. I'm gonna vox Jack and ask him where he is.
I'm on the bridge. Where do you think I am?
Is there any disturbance going on up there?
We've locked down the bridge and we've guards posted. Nobody's come this way yet, but it's only a matter of time. It seems to be starting from... excuse me. The gun decks.
Captain, I don't think I'll be able to get on the bridge or necessary up there.
Then you can come with if you want. It's your call, Hayato. You go where you think you're going to be of most benefit to put down this revolt.
I'm going to pull out my pistol and say, I'm coming with you.
Very well. I vox on my personal guard channel to find out locations and try and get them all together. To start going deck by deck.
Biff, we should still be in our equipment from... in our landing equipment, right?
Yep.
Okay.
I silently follow Marius.
It has been 4 hours. Ionessi, I believe that you did not roll a natural 5 on your power armor.
I didn't roll at all for the power armor.
No, I made you roll. I remember that.
Yeah, okay, I don't remember you rolling.
But since I can't remember what you rolled, you have only an hour left of power, maybe.
Okay, I'm fine with like going back to my room. I need some time to be withdrawn and quiet and think. So I watch like Marius get up out of the blood and stop praying, and I'm just like sitting there like in the blood, and he walks off, and I'm like, Then I'll go to my room.
Okay, Marius and Hayata and Claudette, you all are heading towards the mutiny?
Yes.
Cornelius, what did you want to do?
So I just wanted to make sure the ship was okay now. That's my priority, I guess. At that point, I'll be doing the same kind of thing as INS, so just withdrawing to reflect, I guess.
Ship reports that she's recovering. She's aware of the damage, but felt it was necessary to root out the corruption with it. She does explain, though, that there's some troubling feeling within her.
Is this from the crew, or...?
Yes.
Okay.
Seems to be... flashes. She suspects there's fighting.
I will liaise with the captain, make sure he knows what is going on. Any information you could provide would be more than prudent. However, your current state, I believe it's important you rest.
She doesn't really have much specific information to give, just that it seems that the crew is fighting itself. There's outbreaks across the breadth of the ship. That's about as specific as she can get about it.
Okay, so that'd just be me basically saying don't worry yourself about that, but if there's anything that you need, I'm always available. It's basically saying the major threat's over. I'll handle the little things.
She sort of curls in on herself and begins to sort of enact self-repairs, if you will.
Yeah. So when I kind of make my way back to the Engineering, I just kind of permanently hooked into the system monitoring and in communication with Marius, should he need me.
So you're heading to the Engineering?
Yeah, to provide kind of remote support.
Okay.
I order Octavius to send a guard with Cornelius.
He sends two.
Just in case.
Okay. Over or under, Cornelius?
Let's go for under.
Under it is. Though there is fighting breaking out, you are going to be able to make it to the Engineering. You can tell that Octavius has posted a significant portion of the forces loyal to him here in the Engineering.
Oh, so it's a kind of bastion.
Make what assumptions you will. You could always ask him about it.
Yeah, I don't really have much intention to speak to him. I would make sure Marius is aware of that, though. Marius, Captain.
Very well. It seems Octavius is defending the key systems on the ship. I trust his judgment in these things. He spent a long time with the Imperial Navy and the Imperial Guard. I'm sure this isn't his first issue on shipboard.
Yes, I believe his expertise is more profound than mine in this aspect. However, if there's anything you need, don't hesitate to contact me.
Mates, your group begins making its way to the closest outbreak of fighting, I guess?
Okay.
I mean, what you tell me, yeah. Is that what you wanted to do?
Yes. I want to get, so myself, I'll leave Octavius to do what he needs to do, and, I don't know, go down the other side of the ship, so we're clearing the same decks at the same time. But myself, Hayata, and Claudette, along with my personal guard, are heading through the ship to find anybody who's any dissent and put it down.
Make a scrutiny check as you order Octavius to, you know, sort of split off from you.
Ooh. Bang on.
Octavius gives you a tight nod. Anger seems to burn within his eyes, and he heads off with some of his men.
Before he turns, I vox him personally on his closed channel and say, cousin, if there's anything you need to say, you may speak freely. I do not hold judgment to you. No, private channel, Cornelius.
He stops and motions his men to stop. He doesn't turn back and face you, though. Say, what is there to say? We go off half-cocked, using Eldar webways and dark Eldar contacts and Kroot who eat our dead, who have served you loyally. What else is there to say? We have astropaths and navigators that are out of control. They do what they want. Who pays the price? Not you. No, not you, dear cousin. Us.
The price is on my soul, Cornelius.
The price is on these men. The price that they have already paid. How many have lost their minds, their souls, to the very corruption that you have invited within this ship?
corruption is something we fight against each day, cousin.
Don't you lecture me on fighting the corruption. I've been in the guard. You have not.
Did I have not? I spent my youth not in an officer's mess, but in the fighting pits. You talk to me of sacrifice. I know what it's like to be in the belly of the beast. I stare corruption and insanity in the face more times than you will ever know. The last thing I need is dissent among my officers. If you do not feel that you can serve under my command, then when we reach the nearest starport, feel free to hand in your commission. Until then, you will trust my judgment, and you will carry out my orders. And rather than brooding on these thoughts, you will come to me as soon as you have an issue, and we will discuss it, and we will find a way around it. Is that clear?
Make a command check.
At minus 10.
You're going to get a minus 10 for conditions.
Yes.
But you're going to get a minus 10 for your mental trauma as well, so factor that out.
I'll take that.
You'll take that?
What's my target number? Can I do better?
You got a 47 on that roll.
Your target is 40.
Yeah, I'll re-roll that.
Alright.
Yeah, damn, that's why I didn't want to re-roll it. Yeah. Big fail.
Octavius and his men continue on down the hall. He does not respond to your last words.
Oh dear. That's Mutiny 2.0. I delete the thing that's brewing there. I continue along with my guard and my and the rest of the group. The group.
All right.
I voxed Cornelius as well. While you're in the engineering bay, use the shipboard scanners. I want to know where where Octavius is on the ship, and use your personal codes to lock away access to the murder servitors.
Of course, I'm assuming you don't want him to observe me.
No, keep it quiet.
As you wish.
I recommend
taking precautions with Octavius. He's unhinged at the moment.
Indeed.
How would you know?
Well, that's my assumptions from how he's been dealing with me, you know, with the whole door situation.
That's fair.
As are we all, Cornelius. The Emperor protects, but I fear we're strayed too far from his path on this one.
I fear during our absence the Astropath incident took a heavy toll on Octavius and his men.
Indeed.
Okay, so you're going to try and keep tabs on Octavius there, Cornelius?
Yeah, and particularly his the honor guard. I.e. the guys that have access to the power armor. I'm assuming
they're my personal guard, not his.
Yes, but I'm assuming that as the master of arms, he would have some sway, perhaps.
Presumably.
Yeah.
What are you doing with your personal guard, by the way?
They would be with me on the bridge and the upper decks, as well as some of them would be at key systems. So life support and engineering and...
How many personal guard did you have?
And we have 50 in power armor.
So and those are your personal guard?
Yes.
Okay, so you have 50 men and you're going to distribute them amongst yourself, the bridge, the engineering, where else?
You said key locations, so like the medical deck, the gun decks, armories.
So armories, and the main armories, not like small armory, like lockers on each deck, but like the main armory, myself, engineering, bridge, and gun decks. If I know gun decks, I would leave be because gun decks can't hurt the inside of the ship.
They have the magazines.
That's true. But that if they try and set off the magazines, then that's they're killing themselves. I'm hedging my bets on that one, that that's not going to be an issue. Because not because for me, my my knowledge of a mutiny would be you do it to take the ship in command, you don't do it to destroy the ship.
Anything else?
No, so bridge, engineering, on me and on the main armory.
Okay.
I think.
What's the spread?
Uh, 20 on the bridge and 10 on the other locations.
Okay, so you send 10 men to the Engineering. Now, the Engineering, we've just been calling it that, but there's several key components in the Engineering, and some of them quite large. The generator itself is pretty massive. It's like its own cathedral-type area. The engines will each be a large section. And then, separate from the Engineering, there is one key component that you're sort of forgetting about. And that's the warp drive.
Oh, yes.
Combined with the warp field is the Geller field.
Actually, scratch that. 10 on the bridge and 20 on engineering. 2 to be with Cornelius all times. And kind of not keep Octavius's men away from him, but make sure that Octavius's men don't need to be standing over his shoulder to see what he's doing. And the rest in the warp room, warp core.
Okay. Claudette, what do you want to be doing? You just want to stay with Marius, or do you want to be doing something special?
No, I would have been, I would do something special when the whole situation is over, but until then, I follow orders and kill stuff that needs killing.
Okay. What about you, Hyatt? What do you want to do?
I would probably stay with Marius. Although, I would stay with Marius. How many people does Octavius have?
Octavius is your arch-militant. He actually controls all the people with guns.
Hundreds.
Okay.
If not, probably.
Yeah, I meant how many people were directly with him.
Oh, directly with him. There was 2 with him when you saw him leaving.
Okay. I think I'm going to stay with Marius and Claudette for now. Oh, is Ionessi still with us?
Ionessi went back to her room, right, Ionessi?
Yep.
Okay.
I'm going to ask Captain. Captain, do you want me to come with you? Or should I see if Ionessi is okay after that incident? I knocked my head at both of the quarters, that one that's filled with blood and the other that's exploded.
If you feel safe getting back to the bridge, then by all means, we'll get into our quarters. The ship is not safe at the moment, Hyatt, and I cannot spare the men to escort you.
That's all right. She just went to her quarters, so I don't expect anything big on the way.
I went to my quarters because Marius and you walked away, but I assume you would assume that I'm in my quarters.
Or going towards the bridge, either or.
I mean, as the pilot, I'm probably very keen that the navigator stays alive, even though we have a second one who is also pretty good. But yeah, I'm gonna head to Ionessi's quarters.
Okay, well, they're next to the bridge.
Well, I'm gonna head into that direction then. Should be close to my quarters as well, right?
Yeah.
Right, I'm gonna do that.
Okay. Marius, you and Claudette, along with some of your personal guard and some of the men that Octavius left with you, make it to the first sort of breakpoint. There seems to be a lot of fighting outside of the medical areas. You sort of run up behind this motley group of people that are making their way towards the medical area. There's fighting going on between the people defending the medical area and these people.
So the guys in front of me are presumably the mutineers. There's no way of knowing, is there?
You can make what assumptions you will. Don't forget you can always make checks.
Yeah, I want to try and work out which are the friendlies.
How would that work? Like a perception check? Can I jump in there and maybe overhear or see, like, I don't know, ripped sigils or stuff like that that makes them traitors or something like that?
You can both make awareness checks.
Okay.
I see nothing.
So I got unnatural perception, and awareness works of perception, right? But that does that sure factor into that?
It factors into your degrees of success.
Okay, so I don't get any modifiers to roll, right?
No.
Okay, good. That's a crit fail. So, would that mean that if I get it wrong, we could attack the wrong people? I assume so, right? So I should reroll that.
Are you rerolling it?
Yeah, I'm rerolling that. I don't want a crit fail. There we go.
You can tell that the people nearest to you that are fighting their way towards the medical deck have seen you, have recognized, obviously, you, Ethics Crute and Marius, the rogue trader. But they're not turning to attack you. They're keeping their eyes focused on the prize, if you will.
Yeah, so I look to Marius and say, they are with us.
Very good. I vox to Jack on the bridge. Jack, shipwide emergency. Everybody locked down, return to quarters. Apart from the Marines on board.
Sir, you know that we don't, I mean, you have your personal guard, but we don't actually have any, like, really trained personnel. It's just crew fighting the crew out there. If you remove the loyal crew, you'll just leave them in mirrors.
Well, fair point. Belay that order.
Just have the loyal people return to their quarters, seal the doors, and then we flush the whole ship.
Yeah, that's a rash call. Put me across shipwide vox.
You're on.
Crew of the Invictus. This is your captain speaking. Now is not the time to be fighting amongst ourselves. If you are, throw down your arms and report your commanding officers. Anybody who chooses to stay and fight and oppose my command on the ship, then you will be put down and you will be brought to justice. I carry a warrant of the Emperor. To go against me is to go against his will, and you will be found wanting. Then I cut my box.
Are you trying to command or intimidate?
I am trying to command them to go back to their quarters, or charm them. I'm not trying to be intimidating, I am just trying to be straightforward and matter of fact about it. So yeah, I am commanding.
Okay. You've done a good job on your troop disposition. So, go ahead and make your command check. Don't forget your negative 10 from your mental trauma, because while you make that little speech, you have the compulsion to be making that prayer. So, mm-hmm. You know, your speech isn't quite as together as it was when you said it.
Fair enough. So just at a negative 10.
Yeah. You can take a plus 10, sorry.
So that'd be 4.6.
4.6. All right. You can tell that there's like a lot of resentment sort of all around, but the fighting near you seems to peter out. And you're getting word from Jack and Cornelius, you can see this as well, that fighting in general is sort of winding down, if you will. Everybody's sort of standing down. It takes a while, but sort of everybody kind of goes back to where they're supposed to be. There's a lot of tension on the ship, though. Roll two separate 1d5 rolls.
Five. Okay. Four and one.
Your crew morale is at 58.
Okay.
Your crew population is at 82.
Okay. We have a problem. So all tests involving boarding actions, repulsing hit and run attacks, fighting fires, and making emergency repairs suffer a -5 penalty at that level of morale.
Yep.
Plus anything else that you want to impose on us.
No, I mean, you did pretty well at managing the mutiny. Yes, you got that right.
Awesome.
You have no astropaths. You have no astropathic choir. You have no way to communicate beyond Vox communications now.
Okay.
You do have the Eldar device, the Dark Eldar device. Or no, you destroyed that, didn't you?
The which one?
Yeah, they burned everything.
Yeah, that's right. The one that Desario tried to use on you.
Oh no, I've got that still in my possession.
Okay, well you do have that. You know that that is a communication device of some sort. Desario towards you that much.
Okay, that's hidden. That's only I know that I still have that in my possession. None of the other characters do. Because I was the only one in the room.
Yeah, sure.
I vox to Jack, and Jack, I thank you for your support today. I knew my trust was well placed in you. I would request that you arrange with the senior officers under your command to get... I wish to get all the animosity out in the open. I wish them to conduct questioning of their men, find out what is irking the crew so much. I seek to redress these issues as quickly as I can. I expect your report by tomorrow morning.
Yes, Captain. I'm sorry, Captain. It shouldn't have come to this.
No, this is not this is on my actions and mine alone, not on you. As I said, I wish to know what is bothering the crew, and I will seek to redress it as quickly as I can to stop you being in this position again.
I'll have the report for you as soon as I can.
Thank you. And then I want to go onto Octavius's channel as well, privately.
Okay.
Octavius, we need to sit down and have a meeting. We cannot have animosity between us for the good of the house.
That is easily cured.
Very well, then come to my quarters and we shall discuss it.
I will head there as soon as I finish my duties.
Very well. If you need anything further from me, then let me know, and the assistance will be yours. I want to leave my guard still on guard duty at their posts where I've set them, just until everything does settle down.
Are you telling me or Octavius?
I'm telling you, sorry. It's kind of out of character. I don't change their orders, and they will only take orders from me rather than by Octavius's command. And if he's got any issues, to come to me. So I do tell Octavius that, and the rest of my guard, I tell them to remain in position.
You tell him that he has no control over your personal guard?
No, I tell him that I have requested my guards stay at their posts in critical systems to ensure their safety for the time being.
That is wise.
And then I return to my quarters. I thank Hayata, and if she wishes to return to the bridge or take some downtime, then she's more than welcome to. She can return to the bridge if she wishes to check in on Frank.
She's with INS.
Oh, of course she is. Sorry, I thought she was still with us. It's just me and Claudette. Claudette, I think you would be safer not to be on your own at the moment. I believe some of the animosity on the ship is directed your way. It may be wise for you to come with me for the time being.
I don't think right now you should be with me. You should establish your position, and I'm not helping. And then she puts a hand on your shoulder just for a second, walks past you and leaves, takes out the comm device. Yeah, headed to her quarters.
Okay.
Fair enough. I'm not going to argue with the crew. And I
you better don't.
And I return to my quarters and with my the 10 guard that I've got, and have them posted nearby. Because my quarters would be quite close to the bridge, wouldn't they?
Yes. You return to your quarters. There's a familiar person waiting outside of it.
Who is outside?
Wayne.
Ah, wonderful. Ah, Wayne. Nice of you to drop by.
He drops to a knee.
Lord Captain.
I kind of gesture him to stand up. What do you have for me?
I'm sorry, my lord. I should have seen this coming. I was gathering the information, but I didn't think it was coming to a head so quickly. And then the astropaths, they went mad. It sent everything boiling over.
And what information is it that you have for me?
Well, it's sort of minor, but I'll start with the small stuff. There's been serial killings, or at least we assume they're killings, going on in the lower, in the engine spaces and the gun decks. Most of the press gang crew or low order members that nobody really misses right away have gone missing. We don't know where they've been going. I haven't been able to track them down. I've checked with the mortician, but he says that there's been no new bodies coming in, though I'm certain that now there will be more. Perhaps in the aftermath of all this, we can find some evidence of what's going on. But the crew, I already know, they have a feeling for these things. Somebody is killing us off.
I believe I may have a lead myself in that one. Hyman, what's his job? What's his title again? I can't remember it. The guy that grounds people.
The mortician, right? He is the mortician.
Oh, he's the mortician.
He basically. Anybody who dies goes to him. He does. He dumps them in a food processor, but he's still called the mortician.
I believe I may have a lead of my own on that one. But do we know?
Do you want me to look into that, my lord?
If you could, but stay. Stay safe and don't poke too deep. The last thing I want is for you to go missing as well.
Of course, my lord. But due to this and a few other things, mistrust is running rampant throughout the ship. There is stronger evidence of somebody behind it, sort of directing this ill intent as it grows. I've only caught snatches of a misidentity. The men call him the Eagle.
The Eagle?
That's a bird pun, isn't it?
I am.
There is a growing sense of unease. You can tell that he's trying to put this very delicately about our actions that have been taken.
What actions are you referring to?
I would never question you, my lord, but actions that led to, well, me being tortured by the Dark Eldar and the Kroot. The men feel uneasy around the Kroot. It's like he's always looking at us like we're dinner.
That is his way.
It may be his way, but it is not our way. I'm sorry, my lord.
No, the reason I put you in this position of chief bosun is that I trust you to speak freely, and that is what you're here to do. I do not wish you to sugarcoat and hide behind ceremony. I wish the truth from you. That is your responsibility.
There's something else, my lord. There's something on the ship.
Oh?
I've only caught, I think, glimpses of it. For a while, I dismissed it. I thought it's just a trick of the imagination. But there's something made of shadow.
Perhaps this is something to bring to our navigator's attention. She has a knowledge of the warp and of these things.
All I can tell you is that I saw, I don't know, runes? I'm not sure. It's a dark, glowing script, green in color, that seemed to make its presence known within this shadow. I've only encountered it in areas where there are no crew sneaking about of my duties to you, my lord. It has yet to attack me, so I do not... I don't know, I can't place it, but I do not think it's what's taking the men. Otherwise, it surely would have attacked me.
Indeed. Where on the ship did you... I know you said in the shadows, but where specifically could you... Did you see this shadow? Perhaps this is something I need to investigate myself.
Mostly in the outer areas, the crawl spaces and the sub-maintenance routine areas, where people rarely go. Some parts of the ship, I'm sure you know, sir, are sealed, not in use.
Indeed. Thank you for coming to me, Wynn, with this information. As I said, I value your honesty and I value your what you do for me. Perhaps next time you will come to me sooner before this occurs.
I apologize, my lord.
I kind of smile a little bit and tell him to thank him and kind of dismiss him. Leave this with me. I will investigate it. Any further information you find, bring it to my attention at once.
Of course, my lord.
And I dismiss him.
He leaves.
I have an idea of what that shadow is. That scares me slightly.
It's our elder employer, maybe?
Well, I can't for life me remember the name of them, but there is a name for their like dark elder spirit ghost type things.
Oh, you mean it could be a remainder of Desario?
No, they're something different entirely. Like they are the boogeyman of Dark Elder. Like even Dark Elder are scared of
but
them.
But don't boogeymen kill like everything?
These ones are particular. Mandrake, that's the one I'm thinking of.
Mandrake visited me.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes.
Well, that's all out of character. Let's focus on
yes, that's all out
in
of
character.
Character.
Let's focus what's in character. So, I'm in my room.
Did you want to be doing anything in there, Claude?
Yeah, sure. We have never established that, but we all have like little personal items that are not in our inventory, right? Not like anything that we can use in the game, but for our characters.
Sure.
And yeah, Claudette has like a collection of little wooden and bony trinkets, like almost like figurines.
Okay.
And like, they're all over the place. Like some seem to be like from incomplete chess pieces, and others seem to be self-made, and at the moment she's like making a new one, and yeah, that's it.
All right. Hi, Ida and Ionesi, what are you guys up to?
She comes. You're
coming to my room, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you can come. I don't let you in.
You don't?
No.
Okay, so I guess I knock, but I guess by that point the
on the outside of the door it says like
Please don't enter.
Like a stupid emo-y thing, you know? Like a teenage like inner and then you get cursed for 1,000 years or something, you know.
Yeah, it's sad smiley face.
Yeah, exactly. Ionesi is cutting her wrists, come back later.
Okay. I guess since I have nothing else to do, I'm gonna follow up on a lead I had ages ago. And yeah, I want
to go to the med bay.
No, I'm gonna go down to Cornelius if he's available.
Yep.
Yeah, Cornelius, are you here? I knock at your door or whatever.
Knock at his head.
I don't answer the door. A servo scroll does.
Great. Yeah, and I guess I enter and I'm not sure what to say, so I'm stuttering around for a bit, and then I say, you know, a few days ago, I guess weeks, months, maybe. Some time ago, I wanted to speak to the medbay because of one of the guys who was wounded by Desario, and I got a really weird thing there. It was a female, someone who acted like they couldn't operate a Voxcaster, and it was really weird. And when I went down there, I guess I did went down just to look around, and I saw the same guy Claudette and Marius saw, the medic guy. So I only saw a guy there. I don't know if that's weird to you, but could it be that the Voxcasters are malfunctioning or something?
Not that I'm aware of.
Do you have any way to trace the Vox call I made?
Pass me your device.
I pass him my device.
I suppose I will try and backtrace communication sent from that device. Like, I don't know, I suppose in the 40k universe, would they have MAC addresses and IP ports?
No. Basically, no. The most information you really get out of his device is that it was activated.
Can he speak with the machine spirit of the device, or does it not have a machine spirit?
Well, I wouldn't really be going for that, because even if it did out of a machine spirit, it'd be very rudimentary. It's not sentient like the Architech. What I would probably try to do would be try to work out the timestamp and see if I could trace the ship's communication logs with the appropriate timestamp.
Okay.
So would that be some form of logic test or?
Yeah, sure. Yeah. See if you can logic out the answer.
Yeah, yeah. Just need to make sure I've not got any benefits there.
You do have some negatives because it's really old.
Yeah, yeah, I appreciate that.
I'm just going to give you a negative 10.
Okay. Just going to have a quick check to see if any of my equipment's relevant. No, I'll just roll it at that. Save some time. There we go.
Okay. It takes a while. You find, obviously, the timestamp, but that pulling that out is pretty easy, and then you sort of correlate it with the cogitator banks of the ship itself, and there's a lot of cross-referencing that you have to do, but you go up to the med bay and you get the cogitator number from the panel there, and then you cross-reference it with your list, and you can see that it was activated at the same time, and which panel exactly in the med bay was used at what time. No problem.
It's definitely made a communication.
That's good to hear. I wanted to see if the guy who fell in shock after the Desaria disaster, if that guy is
nice one.
If that guy got well and got okay. I've asked them if he arrived there and they didn't reply and didn't update me, so I would go down there. Want to come with me? Just as a cue for us to have a duo adventure.
Well, do you really think there's credence in this clue? I think it's subjective.
It's something that's interesting to me. I mean, I could go alone. I walk towards the door.
In the current state of affairs, be unwise to travel alone. I will accompany you, but do not expect much input. The ship is still within a state of disrepair.
Yeah. So the whole walk, Cornelius will just make sad R2-D2 sounds.
Yeah, pretty much. He's just withdrawn in his own mind.
Yes, it had to live through quite a lot, and I'd like pat a door frame or something.
Okay, so where are you going, to the med deck?
Yeah, I guess to the point where the call was received.
All right. You get there. There's a lot of people in the med bay. Some are hurt from small arms fire and flamers and frag grenades and stuff. But there's a larger section in the back that are strapped down to their beds or are in straitjackets strapped down to their beds. There's a lot of raving coming from some of them, but most of them are gagged.
I didn't know it was that bad. I look around worriedly.
What did you expect?
Less insanity, probably.
You've not been exposed directly to the war before, have you?
That is very true.
It's intangible. It's difficult to pinpoint what drives these men to lunacy and madness. Something way, way beyond our understanding.
Still, it's frightening me. It's not like they could do anything against it. It just happened to them.
Just out of character, who did you say if there's any medical personnel around immediately?
There are. There's some med techs rolling around, and the doctor is in. I hesitate to say doctor. The Medicaid is in.
Dr. Mercy.
if you say med techs, are there those servitors? Or?
There are servitors, but there are basically like nurses, more like helpers, if you will.
Are some of them female?
No.
So the female voice was none of them. Can they even speak?
The servitors? No. The people? Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna walk up to the doctor and say, excuse me, I realize that you must be very busy. Do you have any female personnel working in the med bay?
What? No. We don't have any females? God, I wish we had some females working in the med bay. I've tried! But they aren't working, they won't work with me. I mean, they are not qualified. They're not qualified, that's what it is.
Okay, what was his name again? He was... Oh yeah, he was Dr. Mercy. That's literally his name. I'm going to turn around to Cornelius and ask, Cornelius, can you tell me again where that signal came from, the call?
I should be able to locate it. I doubt the Medicaid facilities are well equipped. I kind of throw a sidelong glance at the medicum. Yes, one moment.
What are you doing?
Just trying to trace the exact cogitator bank that I found the communication.
Oh yeah, you know right where that's at.
Yeah. Here it is. This is your interest.
Yeah, I take a look around and I walk back to the guy and I'm like, excuse me, I'm terribly sorry to disturb you again, but
I don't look sorry.
I make a very sorry face.
That's better. Yeah. Say, how about you come down here and work with us? You seem to care a lot about this. You're asking a lot of questions. It doesn't take much. You do seem to be quite the looker. I mean, you seem quite skilled with your hands. Skilled with your hands, yes. That's an important facet of the medical field, being skilled with your hands. I could teach you quite a bit. Quite a bit.
I quite audibly clear my throat.
Back to yeah, sorry. Maybe we could talk about this some other time. It's,
What do you want to talk about then? You're disturbing.
Alex, it's actually not a bad idea to do that. But I called you like how long ago was that, Biff?
It was a long time ago.
Check the time, passage of time, and if you are, geez.
Was it a month since Zaria died, or even more?
I could
tell you the timestamp when you asked that, couldn't I?
It was before you traveled to this system. You guys were still in Felix's system.
Oh, yeah, okay.
It was the day you took care of Zaria, which was before the warp travel.
So it's only been like a week. Or 10 days. Because we left as soon as we killed Azariar. And then we took like no time in the war.
Okay, so yeah, I'm asking. Yeah, about a week or two ago, I called here asking about a patient you should have received. And I got a very weird answer by some female personnel that seemed to be working here. And I don't know, if you say you have no females working here, can just people walk in and use your comm devices?
Wait, say that again? People that were sent to the med bay? When was this? Weeks ago? I mean, we had some live burn victims, but I don't remember anything else.
It was with the light burn victim.
No,
should have been
it
someone...
was the seizuring guy.
Yeah, but it was with a... He came with a light burn victims. Or he should have come with them. So there was a guy having a seizure, and I asked for someone from the med bay to take him and take a look at him, but he didn't come here?
No, I remember quite a few light burn victims from the panic, from the alarm that was sent out, but no seizuring. I would remember seizuring. That's a very careful process. What you got to do is there's a hammer and chisel in the back that we use, and you have to sort of vent the brain with some light tapping with the hammer and the chisel. It's a very delicate process. Usually we just turn them into servitors, though.
Yeah, that sounds very intricate. It's weird. I'm gonna.
You have to be good with your hands.
Oh yeah, obviously. I'm gonna come back to you on the helping issue. While we're flying around, I'll be busy piloting. But since we are standing still right now, and we'll be a few times again in the future, I think. Yeah, I'm actually the pilot. I'm not going to say it like that. That would be bragging. But yeah, I might come down here from time to time to help out a little bit, if that's okay.
Oh, that'd be more than okay. Come by my office, and I'll teach you some things. Yes.
That didn't sound rapey at all. Okay.
In the dark and distant future, everybody is backed up.
Yeah. I'm gonna gather up Cornelius and head outside again. And yeah, I look really worried, and I like pace around a bit in front of the med bay and ask him, Cornelius, can he help me a little?
Cornelius is actually delving into the cadre database. Doesn't seem to be focusing very well with you pestering him. Because of this, Cornelius, you aren't able to find much. Like, yeah, I mean, you can find a listing of people, just light burn victims were checked in. They sent some bodies to be processed. There were some other aberrations in there about bodies that were never processed, even though they were sent to be processed. Just one or two of those.
I mean, I say there seems to be some.
There seems to be also a backlog of bodies to be processed, even though not many bodies have been sent lately. There'd be more being sent down now. But before all this ruckus with the mutiny, there seemed to be about half a dozen bodies on ice down in the mortuary or the food processing center, which is sort of unusual. They process them pretty fast down there, and there's no record of anything coming through the medical deck.
Mercy, your records, who keeps these?
I do.
Might you explain the inconsistencies?
What inconsistencies? I've logged every person that's come in here.
How come there's a backlog of bodies on ice that you may not have seen too?
What are you talking about? We sent a whole slew of bodies down with this whole nonsense with the mutiny.
Before then?
I haven't sent any bodies down. Not in some time, really.
Care to explain this? And I'd beckon him over to view the records that I'm highlighting.
Well, that is strange. But why the hell are you harassing me about it? Why don't you talk to the mortician? They're his bodies, not my bodies.
I need to remind you who you speak to.
No, who?
The chief engineer of the ship.
Well, congratulations. I am the chief medical officer.
Well, maybe you should conduct yourself more appropriately.
More appropriately? You just accused me of smuggling bodies. Why would I care to do that?
I did not lobby any accusations, if you took them as such.
You just said that there was an inconsistency in my own reports, and I told you there was no inconsistency, and then you asked me about these bodies and where they came from, and I told you to go talk to the mortician because those bodies never came through here. Now, I can tell that you're calling me a liar. If you take this feather, I'll take you before the captain.
Okay, then.
Okay, then
what? Let's go to court.
By all means.
You can tell you that he's really hesitant to do that.
Yeah. I'm sure the captain would be glad to hear of the inconsistencies between the mortician.
There's like sweat on his forehead now, but he accesses the panel next to you. And he calls the captain. Captain, this is the Chief Medical Officer, Dr. Mercy.
Dr. Mercy, what can I help you with?
Your cog boy is down here accusing me of lying.
Oh? Why is he accusing you of that?
There's apparently a host of bodies down in the mortician's area and that never came through here. I told him they never came through here. He says that they did and that I'm a liar.
Dr. Mercy, I will look into this for you. continue with your duties and ask Cornelius and Hayata to report, or Cornelius to report to me.
Of course, Captain, but I demand restitution. I should not have somebody coming into my medical deck in front of all these people and calling me a liar.
Indeed you shouldn't, Doctor. Would you rather I came to you on this occasion rather than them coming to my quarters? And I'll speak.
They're already disrupting this place. I'll send them to you.
Very well. Is there anything I can do for you in return to make up for this this inconvenience?
Well, I just don't want them to call me a liar.
Of course.
Coming into my, if I came down to the engineering and pissed on a cogitator, I imagine that I would have to do more than apologize.
You would probably need to wipe yourself off the floor.
Cornelius, do not escalate the situation further. You should not be accusing people of lying without submitting a full inquiry.
There was no accusations lobbied. I simply pointed out a discrepancy in the data. If the accusation was taken as such, it was not implied.
I
told him to go see the mortician, and he said that it was my fault.
I privately voxed Cornelius and asked him, I will explain, do not push the matter further with the doctor. Then I go publicly again and say, Doctor, Cornelius will be leaving, and we will certainly look into this for you. I'm sure it concerns you as much as Cornelius that these bodies are going missing, especially if you were able to...
Oh, not really. I don't care.
Very well. But certainly concerns me. There may be perfectly good servitors going to waste.
I'm probably in the background, and if they're done talking, I want to go up to Cornelius again and say, Cornelius, we should really look at take a look at the mortician.
Do I hear Hyatt over the box speak to Cornelius?
Probably not, because it sounded like you dismissed him. Dismissed the doctor, so he probably just stopped talking.
Yeah, cool. Marius like listening onto the call, just sitting there.
Yeah, except I have no idea how it is there. I only know that Cornelius is there, that's all.
Yeah.
Just before we do leave the Medicare, I was wanting to make an off-the-hand check on one of the people who are in the gurneys, just to see if I can check on the status. And basically, I'm looking to give my own diagnosis and hopefully try and pick on something that he's missed.
Okay. He has a supremely smug look at the turn of events that you pretty much think he was not anticipating. You turn and you try to just look somebody over real quick?
Yeah, so I extend one of my mechadendrites, specifically the Medicaid mechadendrite, to look at one of the bedridden casualties, I guess.
Okay.
Just check on
Go
the
status. Ahead. Make a Medicaid check.
Damn.
All right, he's bandaged him up, but that's really it. He didn't really do any synth skin cultures or really anything besides give him some painkillers and bandage him up. Some okay surgery work, you know, like stitches and whatnot, but nothing amazing has been going on here.
I'm specifically looking for things that he might have overlooked or cut corners on.
Oh, you could call him on any of that.
Yeah, so I suppose I'd... your stitching could do some work. Secondary septicemia could onset very fast.
What? No, the wound is closed. I closed it myself.
and I'd kind of draw his attention to maybe like a loose stitching or like tearing one of the stitches for some reason. Matt, want to check your...
Well, I mean, they all do that. I'll get one of my med techs to fix it. Yes, it was probably a med tech that did that one. I can't remember.
Of course.
By the way, aren't you supposed to go talk to the captain about questioning me?
Yes, I suppose so.
He makes like a shooing gesture.
I do the same kind of thing that we did when I came to the junction. I hover out of the room just to show off a little bit.
Okay.
you hear faintly behind you. Emperor cursed cog boys.
Earth to Hiata.
Yeah. I follow him and outside I say, so the captain wanted to speak to you or us both? Should we look to the mortician before that? Maybe we can find something before we have to speak to the captain about that.
Well, you did drag me out here.
So go first to the mortician or first to the captain or straight to the captain?
You did drag me out here, as I say. It's your decision to make.
Well, I guess it's on the way, so I guess the mortician would be very close to the med bay.
Yeah.
And I'd, Sorry, go on.
Yeah, so let's just head in there. Maybe we can clear things up before we even get to the captain.
It's about halfway between the med bay and the cafeteria.
Great.
Are we not at opposite ends of the ship?
The med bay would be in sort of the middle-ish of the ship, if you will, so that people can get to it. There might be like satellite med bay locations where like a med tech would be, and maybe like a servitor that can stitch wounds, so that on-site help could be there semi-quickly. But the med bay itself would be sort of centrally located.
Yeah, but I thought the mortician and his factory was towards like the back and the underbelly of the ship. So I presume the bridge would be at the front or top.
Yeah, I mean, they're going to be going in different directions. The mortician would be towards the aft, whereas the bridge is obviously going to be up, really. Realistically, it's not forward. It's not at the prow. It's just kind of at the dorsal top instead of the dorsal bottom.
Yeah.
So I suppose once we're out of earshot of the Medicare, I would comms again to Marius with an open channel with Hiata as well.
Oh, hello, Lord Captain.
Hiata, you're with Cornelius?
Yes, I am. We're just heading towards the mortician before we come to you. Maybe we can clear things up before things get complicated.
The questions that you are asking the good doctor concern me. I may be able to explain things before you even set head towards the mortician. Although this is something I would rather discuss in private than over the Vox channels.
All right. Yeah.
Hiata got me from my quarters. I was under the impression this was a sanctioned investigation.
I mean, I on the same Vox channel, I'm like, Cornelius, I came to you with a personal question. I never said anything of sanctioned investigation.
It matters not, but... I wish to, if this is a concerning matter for you both, then I wish to speak with you. before any actions are taken.
Yeah.
Are you guys outside the medical deck, heading towards the bridge or somewhere?
Yeah, I said so.
Okay, you both see a med tech sort of detach himself from the medical deck and slide your way.
Yeah, I guess we'll wait.
He nervously approaches you, Hyra, sending cautious glances towards the intimidating figure of Cornelius.
I mean, intimidating is a little, I'm downplaying it.
Hello, I couldn't help but overhear you were talking about a couple weeks ago. I'm looking for somebody.
Yeah, I spoke to someone on the Voxcaster and about, what is it? What's the word again? The thing that he had. Seizure. About a seizure patient.
I was here when they came in. I wasn't supposed to be, but I was here.
Why are you not supposed to be here?
I'm a med tech. I'm supposed to be here.
All right.
I was just in the back. They didn't see me.
Who are they?
Oh, I... He looks nervously towards Cornelius again. Aren't you... Oh, no. I better get back.
I suppose at that point I would move one of my mechadendrites around him so he can't actually immediately go back. No, I think we should speak about this. Frankly, you don't have a choice in the matter. Come with me.
Oh dear Lord.
That's a good idea, Cornelius. I follow the two.
Where are you taking him?
I'd just quick look into the ship's map and try and find somewhere that I know is off rotation, like a utility cupboard or something.
Did he tell us his name?
You didn't ask his name.
While we were going there, I'm going to ask his name.
Franz.
What? Franz or Franz?
I think it's
Franz. Franz Dietelmeier.
Yeah, I'll say, hey friends, my name's Vita.
Hello.
Biff, that is not the voice I spoke to, right?
No, it's not. I mean, you could try and make a check to see how much you remember of that voice, but you're... This is a male voice, that was a female voice.
Yeah. I thought maybe he was especially soft-spoken or something.
He seems pretty meek right now.
I would be too. Yeah, I follow the guys. Do we find a suitable cupboard?
Yeah, it's no problem for you to find a spot to sort of slide into unobtrusively.
Phrasing.
I'm sorry?
God damn it.
Phrasing. Yeah, sorry. It's me being immature.
It's a sex thing.
Anyway. You have a private area to brace this man in.
Okay.
He looks extremely
Yeah, I look like asking towards Cornelius because he suggested that we should go here.
Look, this isn't my worry. You've got something that you wish to investigate on the captain's behalf. I'm just here to help.
On the captain's behalf?
Like,
oh.
I'm not
don't kill Cornelius. Me. Please don't kill me.
Cornelius, I'm not on the captain. Yeah,
maybe
so...
Maybe not kill you, just lobotomize you, perhaps. Depends on your answers.
I haven't told anybody. I didn't tell anybody about it. I just thought you guys were trying to see what happened. I mean, I know that the captain said to get rid of them. We got rid of them. They're gone. They're gone. It was taken care of. It was made very clear to me by his personal guard that this never happened. I understand. Don't lobotomize me.
You got rid of whom? Did you get rid of the seizure patient?
Yes, they took care of him.
Where did they put? Who spoke to you, or who said something?
The two men from the captain's personal guard. They brought him up here. Well, actually, another man brought him up here. One of the engineers down from subsection 12, Cabiole. They brought him up here and said he was having seizures. And somebody else went to get Dr. Mercy. I may have been back by the drug supplies taking an inventory, and they didn't really notice me at first. And then the captain's personal guard came in, and they tried to take him, and I said that they couldn't take him. And then they were like, no, the captain said take care of the situation. And so they took him, and then That's it. I'm not trying to go against the captain. I'm not part of the Eagle organization or anything.
That's very good of you. Do you know the names of those guards? I mean, he has 100 guards, so
he's got a lot of guards. So I don't associate with them.
Can you describe them?
Yeah, they're huge guys with that run around in power armor with big weapons.
Oh, yeah, but did you see their face or just?
Yeah, I saw their face.
Out of character, those are not like clone troopers who all look the same, right?
No, they're not.
No, just asking. Okay, yeah. So what did they look like? Did they have anything that we could distinguish them from? I guess
I'm not gonna go against the captain on this. Like, you tell the Eagle that I no.
Sorry, what did you just say?
Okay. It's fine. I can.
What did you just say, Franz?
What? No, I'm not going to go against the captain. I said I'm not going to go against the captain. You just tell the Eagle that I don't want anything to do with that. I just want to sell a little bit of drugs on the side. That's all I was trying to do. A little bit extra money. No big deal. Nobody miss it. It's not like the doctor would ever use it. Yeah, the Eagle. That's who you work for, right?
Yeah, sure. I buff Cornelius in the side. Yeah, the Eagle. We'll actually go to him like really soon.
Yeah, well, you tell him that I will just stay on the sidelines. Whoever takes control, I don't care. I just do my job.
Yeah, the Eagle might have some use for you soon. Just stay ready. Stay at the ready.
No, I just said I'm not taking sides. I'll do what the captain says. Whoever the captain is, I don't care. The Eagle, Lord Felix, I don't. No.
Okay, so we established that Lord Felix is not the eagle. Okay, great. I look questioning to Cornelius if you want to do anything else with a guy.
Now just kind of give him a withering gaze with my cybernetic eyes. That's it.
Remember, you didn't see us, right?
No.
And we didn't hear anything about any drugs missing.
Oh, that'd be a solid, yeah.
Of course, and I like usher him out of the room and take Cornelius with me.
Worrying.
We totally need to speak to the captain.
Agreed.
Do we want to switch to someone else for now? Or just continue on?
Did anybody else have anything important that they wanted to be doing?
I'm playing with puppets.
Yeah. Did you want to be doing anything else during all this time?
Well, I don't know. Have 15 hours passed yet? Not yet, right?
No.
Okay. I'm the only one who can act.
So I would say 10 hours have passed by the time all the mutiny stuff has kind of settled down.
Okay, so I'm just, you know, enclosed in my room, and unless somebody visits me or the 5 hours pass, I will be on the sidelines.
Okay, INS, see you.
Also waiting to be less withdrawn.
Are you guys going to the captain? Because if you are, then Marius, I'm not going to ask you if you're doing anything because they're coming to you.
Yeah.
We're coming to him. Unless Octavius arrives before they do.
Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot about that. Yes, let's take care of that. He would have already arrived.
I kind of gesture him into set.
He stands in like a parade rest.
Octavius, I wish you to speak your mind on my command. I do not wish this to be at odds.
If we are at odds, it is because you have put us there. I have already told you. All the Xenos shenaniganry. Why do we not approach the Inquisition and get rid of them?
The Inquisition uses Xenos as well. They are tools and weapons for us to use.
Sanctioned Xenos. These are not sanctioned Xenos. They control you. They have their fingers in you.
The Kroot have no such power. And I have dealt...
I'm not talking about the Kroot.
I've dealt with the Eldar.
You dealt with a Eldar.
Indeed. And which other ones do you see on board this ship?
I see none. But I know that that Eldar, he was not who you are in league with. It was painfully obvious. You are telling me he was who you made the deal with to get out of prison? He was weak and foolish. You killed him instantly.
Indeed I did, as I will kill any who oppose our family's resurgence. Believe me, I'm not controlled by a Xenos. I made my pact to get out of prison, yes. And I...
Is that not why we were at the system? I was there on the bridge.
Indeed it is. And you recall what that Xenos asked?
We were to enslave these people.
And have we?
Things. They are Xenos. And no, we have not. Why?
Because I am not at the command of a mysterious figure in the dark, cousin. he gave me a lead on where an exotic animal could be found, or an exotic Xenos could be found. Potentially a very lucrative arrangement. Now, it is not in our interest to enslave these Xenos. We will leave them be.
Why is it not in our interest? We do not have to take them to these dark masters or whatever. Take them to the Inquisition.
The Inquisition will be informed of their location. Believe me, cousin. However, it is not as simple as contacting the Inquisition after the incident with the astral paths.
We need to put into port.
Indeed we do. Cornelius has obtained star charts and routes from the Xenos on the planet, of which we will use put to good use to find our way back to Imperial space. All I do is for the good of our family and for the good of this crew. Yes, we will lose people, and yes, I am not happy about that loss. But up until the point where we reach this planet, we are stranded in space with no star charts and no maps. Now we have a potential path back to Imperial space to do the Emperor's work.
Where we are not sanctioned to be. Am I not correct?
I have made contact with the Inquisitor. She knows of our arrival.
This surprises him.
We have sent very many messages to our contact, who has reached out to the Inquisitor to inform her that we are here. Yet we received nothing back before this incident. So I do not know what will await me when I return. But you can be sure that if they are to enact retribution on us to be here, being here unsanctioned, then that is my fate to bear, and you will continue as Lord Captain of this crew. Until that time, I am in command.
You can tell he wants to say more, but doesn't.
Octavius, you are some of the only family. We are the only family left. There's not many that have the blood of Felix running through their veins anymore. We cannot be at odds. We must be on the same page, and we must work together. If you have any problems, or you know, you can speak freely with me. I'm Lord Captain to the rest of this crew, but you're my cousin first.
Make a charm check. You're going to take the negative 10 for your condition, and you're going to take a negative 10 for...
Oh. Sorry, I was doing negative 10. So that's 1.3 degrees of failure.
Are you keeping that?
I don't have any more fate points, so yes.
I will do my duty. And that you can trust, cousin.
Very well, Octavius. If you require anything of me, then you know where I am.
He turns to leave.
I let him go.
Okay. So, Cornelius and Haida, you arrive.
Yeah, we do we see Octavius leave?
Yes, you do.
I'm just whispering, not necessarily to Cornelius, just to anyone. Oh, great, he must be in a great mood.
I'd incline my head towards Octavius, just out of respect.
He eyes you, but doesn't make any negative or positive reaction. What are you two doing here?
Just about to speak to the captain.
Anything that I should know about? Things on the ship are not well.
Yes.
I don't want to be surprised again.
No, just the routine reports on the ship's health. Letting me know how Invictus is holding up.
Make a deceive check.
Oh god, that's gonna be bad.
You know, make a backflip.
I also don't have deceive, so I can't help you.
Yeah, that's.
What? Are you still? Did you account for your mental trauma?
I didn't put that in there, but yeah, it's nice then.
Even worse. you're like shivering and sweating heavily, and
no, I think it's more the fact that he just says it completely deadpan. It's like there's no attempt to hide it.
You try to say
you should stick with the machines. You would do better there than lying to me.
I'm inclined to actually agree with you for once.
Very well. Keep your lies. He stomps off.
Pleasant as always.
Okay, yeah, we knock on the captain's quarters.
Come in. Hi, it's Cornelius. Thank you for arriving, for coming so quickly.
Captain.
The instant you're... His body's going missing, yes?
Yeah.
I, too, have had reports of this occurrence from one of the officers.
Was it the captain's card in your reports?
Pardon?
We were told the captain's card ordered those people to... be placed somewhere else. So I thought maybe you wanted to use them for something else?
Not as far as I'm aware. However, I did ask my guard to take care of the problem. They may have taken that too literally.
Of what problem?
When the Zarior lashed out against the crew. But it's concerning that I was not made aware of this. I will speak with my commander.
There was a guy I'm still hung up on that. There was a guy. He had seizures, and apparently he'd never made it to the med bay. Was that part of the plan as well?
Not as far as I'm aware, but as I said, my my guard may have taken my command far too literally in this regard.
Should I inform the master at arms that there might be a problem with the guard?
No, I will deal with this myself. However,
okay.
What is more concerning is there's one they call the Eagle.
Oh yeah, he apparently he ordered those people to be missing. Is that you? Are you the Eagle?
I'm not.
Hold on, timeout. If you got the impression that the Eagle ordered that, then that was a misunderstanding.
Oh, okay. Sorry. I thought the Eagle ordered everything, ordered the guard.
No. The guard came and said what they said. The Eagle situation was separate from that. When you said you weren't with the captain, he made an assumption that you were with the Eagle.
Ah, right. I was secret agents just to that one guy. Captain, we spoke to one person in the med bay about this incident. I'm terribly sorry about that. We did that after you ordered us to come straight to you. And he mentioned this. Wait, Alex just mentioned the Eagle to us, right?
He did.
Okay, yeah, so he mentioned this Eagle you speak of.
Sorry?
Want me to repeat the...
Sorry, your voice dropped off for me.
Oh, okay. I just told you that we spoke to that one guy even after you ordered us to come directly to you, which I'm very sorry about, and that he spoke about this Eagle person.
Yeah.
It seems like the Eagle is conducting some fairly illegal things on the ship, like drug trading and stuff like that.
Legality is a thin line.
Well, it's obviously the things belong to the captain. It's his ship, right?
It is not so much stealing from me, it is stealing from the rest of the crew. Though for us, the senior officers, we're never going to be without resources when we need them. It's the rest of the crew that will suffer should these things be going missing. I will bring this to the attention of Octavius myself. I'm still waiting to hear back from Jack and the rest of the officers to find out what is going on in the ship. I feel I have been off it far too long, and I need to be more attentive to the crew themselves. See to those under your command, and conduct your own investigations if need be, but keep me apprised of any actions you're going to be taking. As for the discrepancies on the database, that is partially my doing. Claudette was suffering and needed to eat. I altered the logs to make a body disappear.
So she ate the I forgot the name again. The shock person.
I'm not entirely sure which one it was. I think it was that person, though.
Yeah, it was a burning victim.
Yes.
Yeah, but then was so you ordered her to eat the person in shock, not one of the wounded ones. And I'm like a little bit.
Yeah. I don't go into specifics with Hayato, but. Yes, the person was due to be converted into a servitor. I did not see the harm.
I look fairly disgruntled, but I don't say anything. Since, yeah, I saved that guy.
So, burn victim was sent as the group's personal supply.
Indeed.
That neglects to explain the slew of bodies.
Absolutely. I agree. It is worrying. I will, although I believe I know the source. The mortician is potentially to blame.
How so,
yeah.
He is armed.
Is he using that arm?
I believe so.
Shouldn't we deal with that?
This is worrying. Is this a mortician in a civilian capacity? Why did you feel the need to arm him?
He was uneasy of the crypt. And it was an arrangement we had. The crypt can access whatever food she needs from him. And everybody on board is armed. Civilians and military.
If the civilians are armed, how come you need to arm him personally?
He requested an upgrade, shall we say. He did not want the standard issue las cannon. He wanted something more solid.
I'd be worried if you gave him a las cannon, sir.
He's not dealing with Lehman Ross's down there. He is a bolt pistol. Not a bolt pistol.
Stub revolver.
Wasn't it a hand cannon he got?
No, because we didn't have any on board, so I gave him a stub revolver.
Are you leaving out the part on purpose, or are you forgetting what you had attached to the stub revolver?
I don't mention that to them.
Still, it doesn't seem... It doesn't match up, one person.
Why don't you go ahead and make a deceive check? Because you've said a lot of shaky things to these guys.
Alex is great, and oh wow, this one. Is it a post or just straight?
Against NPCs, it's not a post, but in this case, there's going to be a scrutiny test in opposition of the deception.
With any bonuses or just straight out as well?
Just a straight. Take what bonuses you normally get.
Mine had my minus 10 included.
Damn!
Wow! What? You crit failed.
Screw it, I'm going to reroll that. Use my last fate point.
I will use my fate point to reroll mine as well.
Oh, come on.
God damn it.
Damn. Nice.
Okay, continue on.
As we all know, there are ways and means of getting things on ships that one shouldn't control. It's clear from your description of this person in the medical bay that there is a black market running. Whether he's found other armaments for him and his team remains to be seen.
What, so you're worried that you've armed a fanatical mob, perhaps?
Well, when you put it that way, Cornelius.
No disrespect, but the current climate with the crew may lend some credence to the worries.
As I said, I've made it perfectly clear. I'm happy for all crew to carry a sidearm if it makes them feel safer. Standard policy on this ship, especially if we're boarded or a problem occurs on board, which we have faced several times.
Will you be seeing to the murders yourself personally, or are you removing yourself?
It is a suspicion on my part. He told me it was personal safety for the crew. He he felt that a las pistol wasn't enough. I was not going to correct him that a stub revolver wouldn't be much better.
Not to be disrespectful, Captain, but did you specify any specific parts of the crew that are, I posited, that are fair game, or should we all be afraid and walk around?
I did not instruct them to go killing Hayata.
So we should arm ourselves while we're on the ship.
All of the crew should be armed.
All of the crew be armed? What?
Yeah, all of the crew are armed with side weapons, side arms.
Really?
Yeah.
And flamers.
He said episode one, Johan. They said
they're not like wandering the corridors with flamers.
What you guys said at the beginning. They were all on a sidearm and a flamer.
That's why they are burn victims every time.
Why do you think there's so many burn victims?
There are flamers in the armories if they are needed, but there are they're all armed with standard issue sidearms, las pistols, or stub revolvers, whatever. Dealer's choice on what type of pistol they have, but they're only armed with pistols. Unless there is a call to arms in which las rifles and flamers and other weapons, shotguns, etc. are handed out. But that's Octavius's responsibility.
And is he back on the team?
He is set in his ways, Octavius. It will take more than mere words. He responds better to actions than he does to words.
Sorry, I'm already way out of my waters, Captain, but we met Octavius out there and he seemed disgruntled that we would not tell him why we were here. Maybe it's a good course of action. Like a first step to include him in this investigation?
Indeed, I will inform him. And I cannot open my voice to Octavius again. And Octavius, I know he's just spoke.
Oh. We're going to cut off there.
Oh, okay.
Okie doke.
We'll pick that conversation up next week. But before we end tonight, there's some things that we need. You all need to make checks to see if you retain any special equipment that you have. There was a mutiny. So your power armor and your heavy bolters, any special ammunition that you have, you need to make sure that you still have the same amount of supply of these. I will tell you in Discord either today in the next couple of days what that modifier is going to be. And then if you guys could go ahead and make those rolls before next session for your own gears and stuff like that, we'll see if you've retained it throughout this time. This is sort of going to be a bad situation because you had a mutiny. You guys are in deep space, cut off from your normal supply lines. Like, it's not like you made any supply contacts here in the Jericho Reach. So perhaps your specialty ammunitions were looted or destroyed in the fighting or whatever. That's sort of how that is simulated. It's a profit factor roll to see if you maintain it. These things will be happening from time to time when I deem it appropriate. This, like I said, I wanted to give you guys time to get into the game, and this is our sixth episode, so I figured it was appropriate to see if you maintained your supply or not.
Just the ship's stuff or also personal supply?
Personal supply. You know, things like if you have a conversion field, clearly you still have a conversion field, but things that exhaust itself, then you need to check and see how much of that you have left. So specialty ammunition, that's going to be something that you don't carry all of your specialty ammunition on you. So you need to see if you still have a supply of it. If you had anything that you left on the ship and didn't take with you down to the surface, need to see if that was maintained.
See, I've got a bloodlock bolt, right? Which helps protect my stuff.
A what?
A bloodlock bolt.
Your personal stuff, yes. But yep. You have a nearly infinite supply of your ammunition. Are you saying in your room you just have boxes and boxes and boxes of ammunition?
That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
I retract what I said.
Out of curiosity, is the fact that I posted troops on the armory, is that going to be a factor in...
Absolutely. That will help you out. Absolutely. Okay.
Thank God for that.
And you can always get these things back once you make it back to civilization.
Nobody's going to steal my puppets, though, right?
Nobody. That is unlikely. But like I said, things that are, you know, personally yours, like you have this one gun. Yeah, you still have that gun. That was on you. That was your thing. You know, it's reasonable that you had it in your room and nobody got to it. It's reasonable that there's still standard ammunition for it. But specialty things you need to check and see. I'll give you a better explanation of it if I can when I tell you your minuses and positives.
Yeah, so things like our organ grinder rounds, they're going to be in the armory. They're not going to be in our rooms. So that's at danger, effectively.
Yes, things that you have a huge supply of, essentially.
Flavors, all of the flavors have went missing.
it's just going to be Ross rolling for the next week.
Yeah, you're gonna have like at every corridor, like crossroads or T junction, you're gonna have like, you know, guards patting down people for flamers.
The mutiny didn't get that bad, so I don't imagine you're going to lose very much. But you never know; the rolls can get weird. And if you roll like you did tonight, then you probably lose everything.
Yeah.
The eagle might have used the commotion to get some stuff.
He might have. That is very good insight there.
Also, I propose that we check the crew logs for everybody with the, you know, partially named with Aquilas or Aquila. Yeah, Aquila.
Yeah. Out of curiosity as well, it's clear that the kind of impression I'm getting so far is there's obviously a sect on the ship that's not happy and they're kind of running a mutiny. And in theory, if these items have went missing, they will be in the hands of the mutineers. If we follow that kind of arc and solve who's the mutineers, in theory, could we recover the items from them?
In some cases, yes. Some things will have been battle damaged. Some things, you just lost your line of supply. Like, you just were running low and, oh, wait, we're in the Jericho Reach now. I'm not in the Calixus sector. I can't just go to Frank and have him ship me another load of those things. When you get back to humanity, then you can set up new contacts that would be more stable.
Yeah. Cool. Cool.
All right, any other questions about that?
Nope.
None.
Okay, any feedback on the session tonight?
I had a lot of fun.
Yeah, I liked it.
It was my favorite session so far, and I did not think you would be able to top the last one, but I think you picked up really good on the input we gave you last time, where Alex was like, would be cool, I know it's not Dark Heresy, but if we could get like some kind of, you know, internal investigation stuff type of thingy. And it seemed like it was set up even before that, and now we could see that. So there's some nice mystery components. And yeah, even though I was silent most of the time, I was immersed. And I mean, there's nothing better than nothing ruining my immersion.
I really like that I had this really faint lead from ages ago, and that it led to something that's actually something that didn't like fizzle out in nothingness, and we wasted like an hour or half an hour.
That is a good point. Everybody who still has a mental trauma, just go ahead and erase that. We'll just call you all straight next time you come in.
Okay.
And now, nice. I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, I'm just saying, nice. That's me no longer praying to the Emperor every 30 seconds.
Now, did anybody want to vote one of you for additional XP?
I really like Cornelius as Sassy Mechanicus, Sassus Mechanicus. I don't know. It just gets to me. And also Haida, because, you know, I like to see her inquisitive nature and her, like, I don't know, she's like very cautious, but also like meddling into things that might be too much for her. And I don't know, I find it interesting how she handled situations. So those two, they make a good combo, I think.
I would name Cornelius as well.
Yeah, I was going to say Hayata, because I liked how she was following up on that medbay thing. And that's now tied into our kind of main story that's going on, which is nice.
Yeah, I'd agree with Hayata, because as Johan's already said there, there was a very tenuous link that you've managed to pick up on.
All right, Hayata, go ahead and take an extra 150 XP. Claudette, you get 50 XP for saying Sassus Mechanicus.
I will use them well.
All right. Well, if there's nothing else, I'll see you guys next week.
What's our flat XP gain?
Yeah,
from the session.
900.
900. Cool.
Good game, guys.
Yep. Thanks everyone very much for watching. This was episode 6, okay. Part 2. Join us next week for episode 7, where we'll continue off in the hunt for the eagle.
Bye. Good game.